Hey, I'm Leigh Halliday, and today we're going to get up and running with Google Maps in React in about 5 minutes. So to get started, we've got this home component that's simply rendering out a div that says map. So if we go into the browser, we get this beautiful white canvas that says map. And at this point, it's time to load in the Google Maps script, which loads a whole bunch of JavaScript underneath that's used by the map itself. So for that, we're going to use a hook called useLoadScript, which comes from the package we're using, react-google-maps/API. So we'll put this into a variable, we will call the hook, and you need to pass in an object that has the Google Maps API key, which for now we'll put as an empty string, and we'll hop over into the credentials console, where we can create a new API key. So we'll copy this API key. And at this point, I should say, you should restrict your API key, preferably to like the domain you're hosting your website on. And you may want to go into the APIs page as well and make sure that you have the Maps JavaScript API enabled. If you get any sort of error while you're building this, check the developer tools console. You may get a message that tells you what's wrong. So we'll go and we'll paste this here, but just stopping at this point, we actually shouldn't do this. You shouldn't commit your API keys to your code, especially if you're pushing this up to a public repository. Instead, what we'll do is we'll place this into an environment variable. So in Next.js, you can use a .env.local file, which is not committed into Git itself, and it will pick this up and load it. And wherever you host this website, you'll need to load this environment variable there as well. It's very important in this case to prefix this with next public before whatever name we want, so that next includes this into the client side, into the browser JavaScript, so that it's available to us. So we'll access it with process.env.the environment variable name, and that will give us a variable that we can access here called isLoaded. So with isLoaded, we can check if it's not loaded, we're going to return a loading screen of some sort. So this could be as fancy or unfancy as you want. We're just going to say loading dot, dot, dot. And then once it's loaded, it will render out our map. So if I refresh for a split second, you see loading. But more importantly, if you go inspect the code in the head, you'll see that it's inserted a script tag that's loading the Maps Google API's JavaScript. So we're good to go and we can start working on the map. And I'm going to create a functional component called map that will return temporarily the word map again. And here we will instead use this component. So for the map itself, we're going to use this component called Google Map. So we'll come here and we'll replace this with Google Map. And there's three props you need to pass for everything to work correctly. The first is the zoom. So how far in or out do we want this zoomed? We'll start at 10. It's a pretty good number to work with. Where is the center of the map going to be positioned? So we're going to say center, and it's an object that will have latitude and LNG for longitude. We'll just set it at a place around Toronto in Canada. Lastly, we need to tell it how big of a container or styling the container that the Google map will be rendered into. So for that, we can set a class name, map container class name. And I've already set up some CSS that has a map container that's simply width 100%, height 100VH, so basically the whole screen. So we can come back and paste this in. And if we go to the browser, we should have a map rendering. So great, now let's try and place a marker on it. So we'll go back to our code, and inside of the Google Map component, we'll place a marker. But this isn't enough, because where on the map would this marker be positioned? So we need to give it the position, and we can set it to the same thing, lat 44, longitude of minus 80, and that will place this marker right here in the middle. Now, one thing to note, if you were to like move this screen around, and for whatever reason it re-rendered this component, it would actually recenter itself to this position. Every time it re-renders, it's sort of the map component gets tricked, thinking, oh, you gave me a new center position, I'll recenter the map. To solve this, we can put it into a variable called center. And we'll just copy this right here. This has the same problem though, even if I replace this variable, because every time it re-renders, it creates a new object. And even though it's the same object, it's not a reference to the same internal object. So to solve this, we can either move this outside of the component, so that would solve it, or we can keep it in the component and instead use the useMemo hook. So what useMemo does is it basically, it memoizes the result. And what that means is it performs the calculation once every time the dependencies, which is this array argument here, change. And because we have no dependencies, it's an empty array, it will calculate its value once and then reuse that every single time it re-renders. So now we've solved this problem of it accidentally re-centering itself. So that's it. That's how to get up and running with Google Maps in React. Thanks.